This video tutorial I will explain what is an API. API stands for Application Programming Interface. API is a set of rules and protocols that allows different software applications to communicate with each other. Here you can see the software application which is developed using Java. Here you can see software application which is developed using .NET. And these applications can communicate with each other using API. API defines methods, data formats and conventions that developers should follow to interact with a particular software component or service or platform. APIs enable different systems or applications to interact and exchange data seamlessly. API provide a way for developers to access the functionality of another software component or service without having to understand the complex inner working of the component or the service. Instead, developer can use predefined functions and data structures that is provided by the API to perform a specific task or access specific information. APIs are commonly used in web development, where they allow developers to integrate third-party services or data sources into their applications. For example, the social media platforms like Facebook or Twitter provide APIs, and using that APIs, the developers can access user data, post updates or retrieve information from those platforms. APIs can be used for variety of purposes, like retrieving data from a remote server, sending data to the service for processing, integrating different software systems and much more. And APIs are widely used in web development, mobile app development and various other software projects. APIs can be classified into three different types: web APIs, library APIs and operating system APIs. Web APIs, which are accessed over HTTP. Library APIs, which are used within a programming language. And operating system APIs, which provide access to the underlying OS functionality. APIs can be classified into different types based on their purpose and the protocols they use. And here you can see the different types of APIs. The first one is web APIs. These APIs are designed to allow web applications to communicate with each other or access data and services over the internet. They often use HTTP protocols and can return data in various formats like JSON or XML. The second one is REST APIs. REST APIs are type of web API that follows specific architectural principles. They use standard HTTP methods like GET, POST, PUT, DELETE to perform operations on the resources. And REST APIs are widely used for building web services. The third one is SOAP APIs. SOAP APIs are another type of web API. SOAP API uses XML for communication. SOAP API provide a more structured and standardized way of exchanging data between applications. And SOAP API involve more complex protocols and specifications. The fourth one is library or framework APIs. Many software libraries and frameworks provide their own APIs to allow developers to interact with their features and functionality. These APIs are typically specific to library or framework being used and provide way to access and control their underlying capabilities. Fifth one is operating system APIs. These APIs are provided by operating systems to allow developers to access and utilize the underlying functionality of the operating system. They enable tasks such as file management, network communication, process control, and hardware interaction. The sixth one is database APIs. These APIs provide a way for applications to interact with the databases. And these APIs allow developers to perform operations such as querying, inserting, updating, and deleting data from the database. APIs are typically documented to provide developers with instruction on how to use them, and including the available endpoints, parameters, and expected responses. Common formats for API documentation include OpenAPI, currently it is known as Swagger, RAML, and API Blueprint. APIs are often documented and provided by software developers or organization as part of their services. They specify available endpoints, request format, response format, authentication mechanism, and any other relevant details which is necessary for integration. Then developers can use these APIs to leverage the functionality of the existing software components or services, which saves time, effort in the development process. Overall, APIs play crucial role in modern software development, enabling interoperability, integration, and the development of complex applications by leveraging the functionality of existing services and components. In recent years, APIs has become increasingly important due to the rise of cloud computing, microservices architecture, and the need for interoperability between different applications and services. And the APIs have played a crucial role in enabling the development of complex and interconnected software ecosystems. Here we will see the real-time example of how API is used. Suppose if you want to book flight from IndiGo, then what you can do is, you can book IndiGo flight from, not only from IndiGo official website, but also from Paytm, PhonePe, PayPal, MakeMyTrip, GoIBO, etc. This is possible because of API. Using API, the Paytm, PhonePe, and GoIBO will get flight detail information and booking price from the IndiGo server. And those flight details information and booking price, they will display in their own website. And from that website, user can book the tickets. Now we will see what are the different airline ticket booking APIs that IndiGo airline or flight reservation system has to expose to MakeMyTrip, so that MakeMyTrip can use those APIs and do the booking. Here you can see what are the different kind of APIs the flight reservation system has to expose to MakeMyTrip. The first one is authentication and authorization related APIs. The second one is flight search related API. The third one is flight availability and pricing API. The fourth one is passenger details and selection API. Fifth one is reservation and booking API. Sixth one is payment processing related API. Seventh one is booking confirmation API. And eighth one is managed booking and modification, like cancel or modify. And each one we will see details in the next slide. First one is authentication and authorization related API. Developers needs to obtain authentication credentials like API key, access token, or username and password from the flight reservation system, so that developers can use this credential to authenticate and authorize access to the booking API. The second one is flight search related API. Developers use this API to search for available flight based on different search criteria, like origin, destination, departure date, and passenger details. And this API allows for flexible search parameters and provides option like one-way trip, round trip, or multi-city itineraries. Third one is flight availability and pricing related API. This API returns flight availability and pricing information based on the search parameters. And it also provides details like flight numbers, departure time, arrival time, airline names, seat availability, fare classes, and ticket prices. The fourth one is passenger details and selection API. Once a flight is chosen, the developers can use this API to collect passenger details like names, contact information and passport details. And this API validates and processes the passenger information and allows for seat selection or preference customization. Next one is reservation and booking API. Developers submit booking request via API, which includes selected flight, passenger details and payment information. This API handles the reservation process, checks the seat availability and confirms the booking by issuing the unique reservation code or ticket number. Sixth one is payment processing related API. This API may integrate with payment gateway or provide payment processing functionality. And developers can pass payment details to this API, which securely processes the payment and confirms the booking upon successful payment authorization. The seventh one is booking confirmation related API. This API responds with booking confirmation that includes essential details such as reservation code, flight itinerary, passenger details and e-ticket information. And developers can display this information to the user and provide options to download the e-ticket or email the e-ticket. The eighth one is manage booking and modifications. This API may offer functionality to modify or cancel bookings. Developers can use this API to retrieve booking details and make some changes or initiate a cancellation request. This example illustrates how an airline ticket booking API can provide developers with necessary tools to search for flights, retrieve availability and pricing, manage passenger details, process payments, and confirm bookings. And the API streamlines the booking process and enables integration with various applications like travel agency website, mobile applications, or any other platform that require airline ticket booking capabilities. You can get the Java source code link from the description section of the video. To see the description in mobile, click on this icon and it will expand like this. Then click on this more button to see the description. And in the description, you can see the links. And click on these links to get the Java source code.